this is Angela Blackburn with Blackburn Galleries in Art Talk, and today I'm super excited to have one of our featured artists, Kathy Linden, with us, and she's agreed to talk a little bit about her artwork. And Kathy, why don't you just tell me a little bit of how you got started with your work?
Okay. Welcome, first of all, to my little slice of paradise, and also, many, many thanks to Blackburn Galleries for their support, their encouragement, and promotions. As for me, I am a college graduate with a degree in art. Started out with lots of realism, and over the years, my work has taken on a very, very figurative technique. My signature is color, lots of it. I see it in inanimate objects as well as live ones. You know my work when you see it because of all the color. I use lots of mediums in my work for added interest. And the work ranges, again, from abstract to figurative. The figurative gives an element of realism and the liberty to take it to the next level.
Nice. Very
so
nice.
That's pretty much what I do.
So are you working on a current piece? Would you
yes.
like to show us?
Come with me.
Okay, sounds wonderful.
So I always have lots of works going at the same time. There's never just one canvas. You can see this is going to be a fun piece. Realism in the portraiture, but I will take it to the next level with my use of color. It won't necessarily be honest skin tones, but all the auras I see when I look at something. And this will have an abstract background, but I am going to put images on it. My work also involves many, many layers, lots of texture. I love that, and I love the interest it gives.
Now, do you use pouring as far as the way you do the colors, or is it just you're painted on, or can you talk about the technique a little
bit? Yes, I start with palette knives. I have boxes and boxes of palette knives. They range in many different sizes. My brushes as well. I do not work small.
Ah, very nice, very nice.
So that will give you an idea. I mean, I have large trowels that I use in my work. So people who use small canvases for little teeny tiny works, that's not my forte. I'm big.
That's wonderful, wonderful. I see down here you're also working on a piece. Is that a finished piece?
No.
Or are you still working on that?
Not finished by any stretch of the imagination.
Okay.
I must tell you, I start with a concept in my mind, but I never end up in that direction. I just never know where I'm going with my work. I can start with a white or a black background, and I end up with blues and reds. So it's just layers, and I love the effect of color coming through all the layers. There's a hint of it. It doesn't smack you in the face, but you know that there's been a lot of work put into each canvas. My canvases are very heavy because of the amount of layers that I put on them.
And what's the largest piece that you've worked on that you would consider working on again?
I love working on 6-foot canvases.
Okay.
They're a bit difficult to manage. They're certainly difficult to transport, but that gives you so much liberty and freedom to really express yourself. One last thought. In doing all my work, I try to think about our environment. And as any artist knows, you end up with skins. Leftover paint. I put this together, and of course it's a heart, but it's made up entirely of paint skins, and it's titled Save Our Skin. So with that in mind, I leave you and letting you know that this is my passion and I love what I do and I'm blessed to be able to do it.